I am Ashish Tripathi from Government Polytechnic Mumbai. Today we are going to perform a practical of VI characteristics of SCR. So as we know that our practical is divided into three parts. So first one part is forward blocking mode, then forward conducting mode, then reverse blocking mode. So first of all we are going to perform forward blocking mode. So my dear friends, as you can see, we have a power supply of 0 to 30 volt. After that we have connected a 0 to 10 milliampere range ammeter, and we have connected a pot meter in series with the ammeter, that is a range of 1 mega ohm. And after that we have connected a load resistance, you can see with the pointer, it's a 4.7 kilo ohms, and we have connected our SCR. You can see our SCR has three terminal. The left to right we have cathode, anode and gate respectively. We have connected this cathode, we have given the loads to anode, and the cathode is grounded. So my dear friends, now we will give the supply to our circuit. You can see the supply voltage is equals to the voltage across the SCR terminals. This is 5 volt, and the current is 5 microampere flowing through the load. Now we will check the voltage across the load is 0.02 voltage. That means very low voltage, very negligible voltage flowing through the circuit, because the supply voltage is equals to the voltage across the thyristor. The thyristor is in blocking mode. Now we will increase the supply to 10 volts to get further readings. It's a 10 volt, you can see, and friends, you can see the reading is not changed. You can see this 10 volt across the thyristor, and the load voltage is 0.04 voltage, and the current is 10 microampere. Now we will go to 15 volts. You can see this 14.8. we will further increase it to 15. Now you can see the voltage across the thyristor is also same 15, and the current is 15 microampere, but the load voltage is 0.07. now it increase to 20. You can see the current is 20 microampere, the voltage is 20 volts, exactly equal to supply voltage. But the load voltage is, you can see it's 0.08. Now we will go to 25 volts. You can see this is 25 volts, exactly same. And the load voltage is 0.1 volt. Now we will go to 30 voltage, that's a maximum. We are seeing that we are getting 30 volts and the 30 microampere current. So friends, what we got the conclusion is that the voltage across the SCR is equals to supply voltage, the voltage across load resistance is approximately zero, and the current through load is very less. Now you can see we have the reading. The supply voltage is equals to voltage across the SCR, and the current is, you can see, in microampere, that is very less current, and the voltage is approximately equals to zero, because this SCR is in blocking mode. So my dear friends, as you can see, this is the circuit diagram of forward conducting mode of SCR. You can see we have a voltage supply of 30 volt and 5 volt. The 30 volt we will give to power circuit, and the 5 volt we are giving to control circuit. The control circuit means the circuit which is going to gate. You can see this is a 5 volt we are giving to the gate, but we are not giving directly 5 volt. We have a potentiometer, and by this we will vary the voltage to the gate. We have a microampere range ammeter which we have in series with the potmeter output. After that we have connected a resistance
that will go to the gate. This is the gate circuit. Now we will move to the power circuit. We have 30 volt power supply, then ammeter, then a pot meter, after that load resistance, then we have connected the SCR. After that the SCR cathode goes to negative.
Friends, now we have two power supply. Once I have kept on 10 volt, another one is 3.7 volts. Now we will slowly increase this potentiometer to give the voltage to the gate. Now you can see when the gate is triggered, then we will get the 0.7 voltage across the anode and cathode of SCR. You can see the first multimeter from left to right will show you the current through the load. The second one is the current through the gate, and the third one you can see that is the voltage across the anode and cathode. So you can see the gate is triggered, then the load current is in milliampere. It's increased 2.17 milliampere, and we are getting 35 microampere. That is our current going to the gate. We have applied the two multimeters. In the circuit diagram, you can see now the voltage becomes 0.06. So we will further check our load voltage. That is 9.97 voltage. That is the equals to the supply voltage. You can see the supply voltage and the load voltage is now equal. In the blocking mode, we were getting our voltage across the SCR and the load were same. But now we are getting the voltage across the supply is equals to the load voltage. Now when we increase to 15 volt, we are getting the current is 3.16 milliampere. And the voltage across the load, I will check now. This is the voltage across the load. You can see it's 15 voltage. So it's equals to the supply voltage. Now I will go to the 20 volts. You can see this is a 20 volt, and we are getting the current 4.34 milliampere, and the load current and the voltage across the thyristor is constant, 0.07. Now 0.7 voltage. Now we will see the load voltage is 19.67, that is approximately equals to 20 volts. So we will go to 25 volt now, and you can see the result. The current is 5.5 milliampere, and the second one is a gate current, it's 40 microampere, and we are getting as same previous reading, 0.7, that is voltage across the SCR, anode and cathode. Now we will check our load, it's at 25, exactly equals to the supply voltage. That means the when the SCR is triggered, we are giving the supply, we are getting on the load resistance. So we will go to now 30 voltage, and you can see the voltage across the load is, now you can see the voltage across the load. We will check, and it's 29.4, that is 30, and the current. So the conclusion we got from this practical is the voltage across the load is exactly equals to the supply voltage whatever we are giving. Now we got another conclusion is the voltage across the SCR, that is VAK means voltage across anode and cathode, was 0.7 volts. And the third one is the current through the load is in milliampere, whether in the blocking mode it was in microampere.
This is our third mode of our practical, that is reverse blocking mode.
So friends, the circuit is exactly same as forward blocking mode. Only what we did, we have changed our polarity of the power supply. You can see first we were giving the cathode
to the ground, but now we are giving the cathode to the positive terminal of the battery and the anode to the negative. So friends, now it's time to check out our circuit. So you can see we are giving here, it's a 5 volt to the circuit, and you can see we are getting exactly same on the anode and cathode, but we are getting the current, that is 5.3, and you can see this current is voltage across the load is minus 0.2 voltage. Now we will
change our practical. We are getting conclusion that the voltage across the SCR terminal is equal to the supply voltage,
and getting the current,
the current flowing through the load is very low, that is in microampere range, and the voltage across the load is approximately equals to 0 volt.
The voltage is 0.4 volt. Now we will go to 15 volt. It's a 15.9. You can see the reading is exactly same as a forward blocking mode, only the difference whatever we are getting, the current is in reverse direction, which was in forward direction. Now we will increase to 30 volt. So final, and you are getting the voltage across the load is 0.13, that is as same as forward blocking mode. So friends, we got the conclusion from this practical is voltage across the SCR terminal is equals to supply voltage, then the current through the load is very low in microampere, then the voltage across the load is approximately 0 volt. So one question will arise in your mind is that why we are not doing reverse conducting mode. So friends, the answer of this question is the SCR is unidirectional device. It does not act in reverse. When we give the reverse voltage and to the gate current, then the SCR, due to overheat, it